بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله عز وجل به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد الحمد لله respected brothers and sisters in Islam Every Muslim, every believer that takes the path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to have a balance in his fear and hope and fear from Allah and hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single one of us, while worshipping Allah, living in this world, targeting the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to build a certain balance. This balance is a balance between fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, on the other side, hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No Muslim should lose hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the extent they say, basically, there's no hope. There's no hope of repenting. I've done too much sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, huwa al-ghafoor al-raheem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgives. If you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with mountains and earth full of sins, and you meet him, inshaAllah, worshipping him alone, with tawheed, with that connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will meet you with an earth load of forgiveness. But likewise, the person has to have fear in his heart. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to humanity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him to humanity as a bashir and as a nadir. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to give us glad tidings. If we worship Allah, if we follow the straight path, if you follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you do as you are told, Rasulullah sallam came to give you glad tidings. And also Rasulullah sallam was a nadir. He came to warn us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was sent to warn us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is waiting for sinners. That is there prepared for people that do not follow the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and live in this world without proper understanding. Why they hear, what is required from them, these issues are not clear, punishment is there prepared for them after death and in this world. But where should this balance stand? Where does this balance stand in our life? Most of people nowadays, and I speak from my experience, everyone speaks from his experience. From my personal experience, most people in our time and age have, you know, stretched a bit that hope side. There's hope, and very, very little fear. Basically, everyone, if you ask anyone, a person doesn't pray, he's doing one of the biggest sins in Islam. He's not praying. And you ask, brother, why don't you pray? He says, Habibi, Allah ghafoor raheem. Brother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives everything but shirk, true. What he's saying is 100% correct. And this argument, this dalil he's using in the argument is valid. But the way he's understanding the argument, the way he's putting forward the argument is absolutely wrong. Because true, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor and raheem, but also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wal muntaqim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is jabbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mutakabbir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that people who don't follow the path, there'll be some. If he doesn't forgive subhanahu wa ta'ala, there'll be some punishment for them. Now, the issue here that I tried today to basically scratch, to bring this understanding in our life. How much are we really afraid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Let's be honest with ourselves here. How much are you really, really in fear of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Jahannam, created Hellfire, And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in numerous ayat describes this Jahannam, describes this punishment subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hundreds of ahadith, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes Jahannam, warns his ummah from Jahannam, warns his ummah from the hellfire. Let's really search deep into our hearts. Are we really, really, really frightened from this punishment? Are we really scared like the Sahaba radiallahu anhum were frightened and scared from that punishment and the aqab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or is it some information that we have in our head? You know, news, like news. Oh, I know I'm a Muslim, I know. Jahannam is there, Jahannam is like this, the punishment is like this. And this information has no influence on my daily life. This information you have in your brain is not changing the way you act. When a person is afraid of something, it appears on his body. It appears on his choices, on his actions. There's signs of this fear. A person can't claim, I'm afraid, and we see no change in his life. There's something wrong there. It's just not right. So if we have this proper balance, no one is saying, Ya al-Khalas, Allahu Akbar, too much hope, and no one is saying too much fear. To the extent that, no way Allah will forgive me, and no much too much hope that Allah will forgive me, whatever I will do. Some people have this, both diseases are there. Some people say there's no hope in life. Let's see, I'm going to Jahannam anyway, I might as well, you know, do more sin. And others have too much hope. Don't worry, we're going to Jannah anyway, Habibi, we're Muslims. They say, like who said, like Banu Israel. What did Banu Israel say? I was speaking to some brothers the other day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blamed the Muslims in the Quran. وَقَالُوا لَن تَمَسَّنَا النَّارُ إِلَّا أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودًا. Banu Israel, they said, we are the chosen people. شعب الله المختار. We will only enter Jahannam for a few days. Then we'll go to Jannah, don't worry, take it easy. Don't we hear this talk between our brothers nowadays? Don't we hear this talk between Muslims, the Ummah of Rasulullah talking like this nowadays? We say, don't worry. InshaAllah, Rasul promised every Muslim enter Jannah one day. Allah is Ghafur Rahim. Too much hope and little a'mal. Rasulullah came with this balance. Fear and hope. Al-Khawf wa Raja. Both have to exist in the believing heart. And the ulama are different. Some ulama said, we should have a bit more hope than fear. And others said, no. We should have a bit more fear than hope. But at the end of the day, there's some balance that needs to exist in our hearts. So hope, mashallah, is abundant, alhamdulillah, in our time. Fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I see a problem. I can see from my personal experience a problem. There's fear, yani, but it's covered, it's hidden. This fear, like I said, is not changing our life. It's not changing our actions. It's not enough to stop us from sin. A person doing sin, a person falling in sin. Not only falling in sin, insisting on sin. Yani, I know it's haram, Sheikh, I know it's haram, brother, but I can't stop now. This person, there's something wrong with his fee. The fee factor in his heart, there's something wrong with it. If there was enough fee, the person would be scared, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if I don't know what will happen. If I meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what will happen? So there's something wrong with the fee factor in his heart. The khawf from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The khawf from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like in many, many ayat, he spoke about his rahmah and his mercy. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us the beautiful hadith of his rahmah and his forgiveness subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also warned us. He said in the Quran, وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَهُ. Allah warns you. وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, فَأَنْدَرْتُكُمْ نَارًا تَرَضَّى. I warn you. Speaking to humanity, I warn you from a hellfire. It's a fire, Allahu Akbar, this Jahannam. Who of us nowadays is really, really, really afraid of the fire? Who of us nowadays sleeps at night thinking, subhanAllah, if I die tonight, I might taste Jahannam? Who of us spends 1 hour a day, half an hour a day, 5 minutes, 1 minute a day in a period of fear, subhanAllah, what will I do if I go to Jahannam? This thought, I'm speaking about myself, rarely crosses your head. And when it crosses your head, Jahannam, don't worry, we are the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Though the Sahaba radiallahu anhu were afraid, they were fighting from Jahannam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned one of the Ansar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, a young boy from the Ansar, people of Medina. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was approached to say, so Rasulullah, this person is missing. He's not there, Rasulullah, we can't find him anymore. They asked, who is this person? Ah, they found him in his house. Crying. He's always a companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a sahabi. A young man, Allah Akbar, maybe he didn't do sin in his life. Maybe very, very little sin in his life. The topic of Jahannam, the topic of hellfire, made him so frightened of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Crying. No one sees him anymore, doesn't come to the mosque anymore. So Rasulullah went to visit him. He went to see him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then when Rasul entered, this young man got up off of his bed and hugged Rasulullah and on the spot passed away. Died. So Rasulullah said in the hadith, he said, Jahizu akhakum. And I prepare the funeral, prepare the ghusl at the funeral of this of your brother. فَإِنَّ فَرَقَهُ مِنَ النَّارِ قَدْ فَلَقَ كَبِدِهِ. Prepare your brother for fear of Jahannam. Fear of Jahannam has split his liver in half. It has split his liver in half. Why? What's the difference between us and him? He, if anything, he should be more secure. He laid eyes on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Died from the fear of Allah. Allahu Akbar, Iman, with Rasulullah sallam in the mosque, A'mal, Deen. Really, Allah, in the best of environments, with the best of guides sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and still this fear is there. And us, subhanAllah, we're much further than this. But apparently, when was the last time you ever saw a person crying from the fear of Jahannam? When was the last time you ever personally were sitting alone, as the hadith says, وَرَجُلُ ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ خَالِيًا فَفَرَضَتْ عَيْنَهُ. A person was remembering Allah, and then maybe you thought of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment, you thought of Jannah and Jahannam, and then he started crying. When was the last time this happened? What does this say? This says that there's something wrong. There's something wrong in our hearts. There's a disease that's spread wide in the ummah now. What? This fear factor is not in place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the believers in the Quran. The description of believers. What was the description? The description was that they were secure from the punishment of Allah. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ عَذَابِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing the believers. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ عَذَابِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ. The believers are those who are in continuous, always in continuous fear. They مُشْفِقُونَ. They are fear and fear from the punishment of the Lord. إِنَّ عَذَابَ رَبِّهِمْ غَيْرُ مَأْمُونَ. Verily, 100%, no, that the punishment, you can never be secure from the punishment of the Lord, from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can never be secure. If you are secure, this is a sign of a disease in the heart. If you feel secure from the punishment of Allah, if you're not threatened by the punishment of Allah, then there's something wrong in your iman. Don't say, I'm a high-ranking Muslim. Who's a high-ranking Muslim? The Sahaba were afraid, radiallahu anhu. And you're not afraid? Something is wrong there. There's something wrong in your heart. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns, and read the Quran. We read the description of Jahannam, but our hearts are blocked. The hearts are blocked. It's not touching our hearts. If this fear touches your heart, trust me, it will 100% appear on your actions. People will know, anyone will walk in the street and say, this man is afraid of Allah. This man is in fear of the punishment of Allah. You can see on his face, on his a'mal, on his connection with Allah, on his ibadah, on his staying away from sin, of a quick repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he makes a mistake. You see a person negligent like that, this is a sign that he is lacking the sphere of his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, we need to discuss this. We need to speak about this. Some people, I know, they get upset. We say, brothers, wallah, we're going to speak about the punishment of Allah. Allah is going to start speaking about the grave and the snakes and the scorpions and the description of Jahannam and. Unfortunately now, it became like an unlike topic. We don't like to discuss these things. Speak about Jannah, speak about Qur'an. It's a nice topic. We all end up laughing, go home happy. But speak about Jahannam. This is my topic. This is why Umar radiallahu anhu is quoted to have said, أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ النَّارِ. Remember hellfire? A lot. أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ النَّارِ. Please. Umar radiallahu anhu, concerned for the ummah. The Khalifa of Rasulullah said, أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ النَّارِ. Remember hellfire a lot. فَإِنَّ حَرَّهَا شَدِيدٌ For verily, the heat of Jahannam is extreme. فَإِنَّ حَرَّهَا شَدِيدٌ وَقَعْرَهَا بَعِيدٌ And its depth is very, very, very far. فَإِنَّ حَرَّهَا شَدِيدٌ وَقَعْرَهَا بَعِيدٌ وَمَقَامِعَهَا الْحَدِيدٌ And the whips in Jahannam, the whips that are used by the guards are made of steel and iron. وَمَقَامِعَهَا الْحَدِيدٌ So remember Jahannam a lot. Every Muslim, every believer should always be in this continuous connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, continuous remembrance of death, of Jannah, of Jahannam, of fear, of hope, to always keep that balance, to always keep that, always keep alert with your deen, alert that death is coming, that the Jahannam is waiting, that the Jannah is there, to motivate you to do more a'mal, to be afraid from sin, you always have to remind yourself. But to leave these topics and neglect them and avoid them and speak about dunya, dunya, the world, shughal, money, women, children, all this makes the heart die. It makes the heart far from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It makes it a rough and tough heart. It's not what we want. We want our hearts to be soft. Umar radiallahu anhu is known to be strong. Allahu Akbar. Everyone knows him, a rough man. But when it came to fear of Allah, Umar radiallahu anhu was one of the most fearing slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always in continuous fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. crying from the fear of Allah. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, Aisha said, Ya Rasulullah, if you make Abu Bakr an imam, when Rasulullah was sick, if you make him an imam, you will add, people will not hear from how much he cries when he recites the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are the highest ranking companions of Allah, and they had this fear and connection. So we are more worthy. We are more worthy of bringing these feelings into our life. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described Jahannam a lot in the Quran. And subhanAllah, I speak for myself. A lot of times we read, but we never really have a... Because subhanAllah, the way Allah described Jahannam in the Quran is, you know, a certain description here, a certain aspect here, in this surah, in that surah. We rarely have a full image. We rarely have like a full description. We rarely have this full imagination of how Jahannam will be like. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not also hadith mentions, also he, descriptions here and there. We need to, every Muslim needs to have a whole picture in his head, a whole image in his head, like a movie that you can go, basically go through quickly to remind yourself of what would be the right word to say, how unbelievably scary the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. When we say the punishment of Allah, it's not human made. It's not human design. People say, Allah, torture, Guantanamo Bay, I don't know, people are tortured in the World War, the Gestapo, I don't know what. We have stories of torture that we heard of. These are nothing. This is the old human design. And everything human is full of mistakes, full of shortcomings. But this design is from Allah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides to punish, just that should make us have an enough image. Just for us to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Khaliq, Al-Bari, Al-Musawwir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this perfect universe, everything to the dot, everything to the millimeter, to the, I don't know, everything in every aspect is perfected. The creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how will the punishment of Allah be? Also perfect. The perfect punishment, the perfect torture any human being can go through will be the punishment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared. Because he, whatever he does subhanahu wa ta'ala is the command, is the perfection subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this enough should scare us. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala designed a certain punishment for people that disobey him, for people that lead a negligent life. On judgment day, that fearful day, people don't understand that. That day, we have some image in our head. It's not complete. What will happen to us on that day? What will happen to you when you see Jahannam? Rasulullah ﷺ described Jahannam. Jahannam, as Rasulullah ﷺ says in the hadith, wallahi, it's ajeeb for us to understand. It's very, very hard to understand. But we have to go through these hadith and build a certain image in our head. Rasulullah ﷺ says, وقد عليها ألف عام حتى أحمرت. This Jahannam was lit for 1,000 years. 1,000 years. You light a fire, Allahu Akbar. You make a barbecue, you know, in your backyard. And subhanAllah, after a while, if you come very, very close, you feel the heat. It's what, you light the barbecue in half an hour, Jahannam, وَقِدْ عَلَيْهَا أَلْفَ عَامٍ 1,000 years, and who's lighting it up? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقِدْ عَلَيْهَا أَلْفَ عَامٍ حَتَّى بِيَضَّتْ 1,000 years until it turned or turned red. 1,000 years, and each year is what? By the years of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The day is like 1,000 years. And like 1,000 years every day. This is a year for Allah's time, hereafter time. 1,000 years as such, this Jahannam is being lit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is lighting Jahannam. 1,000 years until it turned red. And then another 1,000 years until it turned white. There's difference in narration. Some narration says white than red, others say red than white. And then 1,000 years until it turned black, pitch black. فهي سوداء مظلمة. Jahannam is not like you imagine. When we imagine fire, imagine this yellowish color, you know, blazes and flames. No. Jahannam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created is pitch black. No one can see. You can't see anything. Dark as, has no light, has no flames. Pitch black, heat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. Alfa'am, and then Alfa'am, and then Alfa'am. 3,000 years being lit, hereafter years. And until it became pitch black. Rasulullah once sitting with the companions of Rasulullah, one sitting with the Sahaba, and then in the authentic hadith, they heard the wajda. They heard a loud bang. So Rasulullah asked, قَالَ أَتَدْرُونَ مَا هَذَا. Do you know what this sound was? Sahaba said, Allahu wa Rasulu wa A'lam. Allah and His Messenger know best. He said, this is a rock that was thrown in Jahannam 70,000 years ago. 70,000. 70,000 years ago. 70 years ago. 70 kharif, not 70,000, sorry. 70 years ago, it was thrown into Jahannam. Now it reached the bottom. So you heard its bang. 70 years. 70 kharif. Ulqiya fi Jahannam mundu 70 kharifan. Fahuwa yahwi ila al-an. It's dropping, it's been dropping for 70 years till now, until you heard its noise. You heard its bang. 70 years from top to bottom. Allahu Akbar. How big is Jahannam? How deep is Jahannam? Rasulullah SAW says in the hadith, يُؤْتَى يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ بِجَهَنَّمَ لَهَا 70,000 زِمَانٍ. On Judgment Day, when everyone is gathered, jinn, ins, human beings, young, old, from Adam alayhi salam's time, on Judgment Day, billions and billions of human beings, everyone is there, everyone is present, every slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there, the angels are present, the anbiya are present, everyone is there on the mahshar, on this land of resurrection, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders that Jahannam be brought. كَلَّا إِذَا دُكَّتِ الْأَرْضُ دَكًّا دَكًّا وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمَ. When Jahannam comes, is brought forth. Rasulullah says, يُؤْتَى يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ بِجَهَنَّمَ لَهَا 70,000 زِمَانٍ. Jahannam is dragged by what? 70,000 ropes. 70,000 زِمَانٍ. مَعْ كُلِّ زِمَانٍ 70,000 مَلَكٍ يَجُوهُونَهَا. With every rope, there are 70,000 angels, guards of Jahannam, pulling it. So 70,000 ropes, with every rope, 70,000 angels pulling it. How big is Jahannam? وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ. Jahannam is brought that day. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانِ. And then and only then, the human being will remember. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانِ وَأَنَّ لَهُ الذِّكْرَى. Now you remember? Now you return? Now you want to repent? Now we realize the truth? وَأَنَّ لَهُ الذِّكْرَى يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِ. Can Allah say? Now he sees Jahannam. يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِ. I wish. I worked hard for my life. He realized life is not here. Life is not in this world. Life starts there. This Quran, Allah is saying to us this in the Quran. Allah is speaking to me and you. We're not speaking to aliens here. These words are intentionally for us human beings. وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمِ يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ وَأَنَّ لَهُ الذِّكْرَى. Some narrations, Jahannam being pulled by 70,000 angels. And Jahannam is alive. It talks, it speaks, it sees, and it's boiling, angry, furious from the sinners, furious from the kuffar, furious from non-believers, furious people that disobeyed Allah, furious from people that neglected the orders of Allah in this world. Furious, boiling hot, angry. So when she sees the kuffar on the horizon, when she sees the sinners, the mujrimeen on the horizon, tazfar zafra, releases this frustration. And the angels apparently, because it's so strong, they hesitate for a while. The angels pulling it, apparently let loose for a second or so. They can't control Jahannam. So everyone on Ard al-Mahshar, every single soul, every close, high-ranking angel and sent prophet of Allah, sent messenger, every creature falls on his knees. And this is the masdaq. This is as the ayah of the Quran says, وَتَرَى كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَاثِيَةٍ. Every nation, everyone, when this happens, when Jahannam is brought forth, everyone falls on his knees. No, but I'm strong, I am powerful, I'm this, I'm that. Don't worry, a couple of days in Jahannam, you forget all this. You forget all your arrogance, all your kibr, all your stubbornness, and every human being falls on his knees. All the anbiya even fall on their knees, and what do they say? Ya Rabbi sallim sallim. Oh, make it easy, Allah. That's the dua on that day. In some narrations, nafsi, nafsi, Allah, I'm only asking for my nafs today. Anbiya, prophets of Allah, they will say, Ya Allah, I will only ask for my soul today, only me, save me, Ya Allah. Except for Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he will say, Ya Rabbi Ummati Ummati, Ya Allah, my Ummah. So on that day, everyone falls on his knees. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةَ يَوْمَئِذٍ يَحْسَرُ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls with everything in heaven. لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةَ. And when judgment day comes, يَوْمَئِذٍ يَخْسَرُ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. On that day, all the wrongdoers, all people of bad, the people of the wrong, they will lose. وَتَرَى كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَاثِيَةٍ. You will see everyone on his knees. وَتَرَى كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَاثِيَةٍ. كُلْ أُمَّةٍ. Every ummah تُدْعَى إِلَى كِتَابِهِ. Every nation Israel, come, take your book. الْيَوْمَ تُجْزَوْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Today is the day of hisab, the day of your account. Today Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you what you deserve. هذا كتابنا ينطق عليكم بالحق. This is our book. It only says the truth. إنا كنا نستنسخ ما كنتم تعملون. You thought we were not there? You thought we weren't watching over you? No. Everything you said, every place you looked, everything you heard in your life, every step you made, anything you did is there in this book. إنا كنا نستنسخ ما كنتم تعملون. Everyone falls on his knees. Everyone is afraid. Everyone is in fear. Everyone is shaking from Jahannam. How will your condition be on that day? Is it really, really worth it for the person to neglect Allah's order, for the person to buy a couple of years in this world and sell the hereafter? Judgment day alone, 50,000 years? Sell the hereafter? Put yourself in a situation as such? Why? Because of this world? My nafs, my shahawat, my desires, why? Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala designed this punishment. This Jahannam has guards. So Allah described Rasulullah alayhi 19 guards. Special leaders. Not only 19 guards. The 19 are the leaders of the guards of Jahannam. 19 guards. In the narrations, the distance between the shoulders is the distance between the east and the west. عليها 19. Allah describes, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Allah speaking to the believers here. قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا. Save yourselves and your families from a Jahannam, from a hellfire. وَقُوْضُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. Is lit up. How is fire lit up? Nas and hijara. Stones, rocks and human beings. وَقُوْضُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. عَلَيْهَا مَلَائِكَةٌ غِلَاظٌ شِدَادٌ لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَ. It has guards, angels, غِلَاظ. Allah is saying, غِلَاظ, شِدَاد, strong, rough and tough. لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ. They never disobey Allah's orders. وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. Allah is warning you and me. Save yourself from Jahannam. Save yourself from this fire, yourself and your family. an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and people are sleeping. And people don't want to wake up. When will you wake up? What more do you want to hear? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us from Jahannam. Rasulullah s.a.w. says, don't think Jahannam is punishment is like you imagine, you see in movies or something. The punishment designed by Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah says in the hadith, your tooth in Jahannam, the tooth of a person in Jahannam is as big as Mount Uhud. Your dirs is as big as Mount Uhud. The skin, masira thalathat ayyam, the skin, the thickness of the skin is a 3-day trip. A 3-day trip of fast, mashallah, fast passing by. Fast method of transportation. 3 days long. Just the thickness of your skin. Preparation of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing. And then Jahannam. In the hadith, we see the kuffar. فتزفر زفر. Allah says in the Quran, تكاد تميز من الغيب. Furious. يعني going off. تكاد تميز من الغيب. About to split from fury. About to split from frustration. It's going to split in half. That's how much Jahannam is angry and furious from the sinners and the kuffar, people that deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And like a flame will get out. This flame has eyes and ears, and this flame will basically start grabbing people on the land of resurrection. Grabbing people like that. Like a bird grabs sesame seeds. Grabbing people. The punishment of Jahannam, Rasulullah says one hadith, will make us understand everything. He says, إِنَّ أَهْوَ لِأَهْلِ النَّارِ the least punishment in Jahannam, the least torture, أَهْوَ لِأَهْلِ النَّارِ عَذَابًا the minimum punishment is a person that يُوضع فِي أَخْمَصِ قَدَمَيْهِ جَمْرَتَانِ يَغْلِي مِنْهُمَا دِمَاهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put two pieces of hot coal under his feet that his brain will boil from. Your brain will boil. This is the minimum punishment in Jahannam. Minimum punishment. What's the maximum? What are people that are average, spending a couple of years or a couple of months or even a couple of days? The minimum punishment. This person will be suffering so much, he will think that he is basically, who has been given the maximum punishment in the world. He will think, I am receiving the maximum torture in the world. وَإِنَّهُ لَأَهْوَنُهُ مَعَ ذَابًا. But in reality, he is receiving the minimum punishment in Jahannam. Minimum punishment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the people, the inhabitants of Jahannam, suffering this fear. Imagine yourself, astaghfirullah al-azim, Allah, we ask Allah that we all save from it. Imagine yourself spending one day or one week in Jahannam. For 1 month in Jahannam, what will happen? The torture of Allah, the anger of Allah, the ghadab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How will you be? Burning, that heat. What will, as the subhanallah Allah describes, what will your food be? People of Jahannam, they get hungry. The human beings, people of Jannah never feel hunger again. Never feel thirst again. But in Jahannam, you get hungry. You're in Jahannam. You get hungry. What's your food? Zakum. You get hungry. I'm hungry. No food. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them what? Zakum. What is Zakum? What is Zakum? The tree. Adhalika khayrun nuzul am shajaratu zakum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, is Jannah a better place, a better abode, or the tree of Zakum? إِنَّ جَعَلْنَاهَا فِتْنَةً لِلظَّالِمِينَ. This shajara is a fitna. Punishment. Tribulation, a test for the ظالمين. إِنَّهَا شَجَرَةً تَخْرُجْ فِي أَصْلِ الْجَحِيمِ. The roots of this tree are where? In the bottom of hellfire. In the pit of hellfire. إِنَّهَا شَجَرَةً تَخْرُجُ فِي أَصْلِ الْجَحِيمِ. طَلْعُهَا كَأَنَّهُ رُؤُوسُ الشَّيَاطِينِ. Allah is describing. It's not a weak hadith. Don't say, oh, it's a weak hadith. Allah is describing. The fruit of this tree, of this tree Zakum, is like the heads of shayateen, the heads of devils. طَلْعُهَا كَأَنَّهُ رُؤُوسُ الشَّيَاطِينِ فَإِنَّهُمْ لَآكِلُونَ مِنْهُ فَمَالِئُونَ مِنْهَا الْبُطُونَ. Verily, people of Jahannam are hungry. You'll be forced to feed from Zakum. You'll take one bite, weapon, you will die. Extreme torture. The punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you eat more. فَإِنَّهُمْ لَأَكِلُونَ مِنْهَا فَمَالِئُونَ مِنْهَا الْبُطُونَ Not only you eat, you are forced to get food from Zakkum. You are forced to get food from Zakkum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in the ayah of Surah Al-Waqi'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَصْحَابُ الشِّمَالِ مَا أَصْحَابُ الشِّمَالِ فِي سَمُومٍ وَحَمِينٍ They are what? People of the left. Who are the people of the left? They are being tortured in Samoom heat, unimaginable heat. The wind that comes, unimaginable hot wind. Samoom wa hameen, boiling water. Wa dhillin min yahmoom. When you run away, when you run away from heat, where do you go? In this dunya, there's so much heat. Where do you go? You find a piece of shade. You search for shade. You go seek some shelter. In Jahannam, so much heat, so much hot wind is coming, you are boiling, you're dying, you search for shade. You find shade, you run to the shade. The shade is more boiling, is more hot than non-shade. وَظِلِّ مِنْ يَحْمُومِ A special shade, special punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What some ulama say, يَحْمُومِ is a mountain. Is a mountain in Jahannam. You go seek shade in it, it burns you more. وَظِلِّ مِنْ يَحْمُومِ Well, in this world, mashallah, they were playing around. Mutrafeen, they don't want to practice, they don't want to do deen, they don't want to follow Allah's orders. They think they're too strong, they think they're powerful, they think they have a lot of time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now, test. وَظِلِّ مِنْ يَحْمُوهُ إِنَّهُ كَانُوا قَبْلَ ذَلِكَ مُطْرَفِينَ وَكَانُوا يُصِرُّونَ عَلَى الْحِنْكِ الْعَظِيمِ وَكَانُوا يَقُولُونَ إِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا إِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ فِي ضَيَاعٍ إِذَا resurrected. قل إن الأولين والآخرين لمجموعون إلى ميقات يوم معلوم ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون لآكلون من شجر من زقوم Verily, every single one of you, the kuffar, non-believers or sinners, you will eat from the zakkum. فمالئون منها البطون فشاربون عليه من الحميم When the people of Jahannam eat zakkum and they start boiling and they get tortured and the pain and. What happens when you feel full? And you have a bad meal, you look for drink. You search for a drink. Nowadays, mashallah, you go eat outside, you have to have a drink besides your food. You want something to eat to help you swallow, digest. People of Jahannam, also human beings, they will eat the zakkum, feel so full, they're dying from torture. So they search for a drink, something, a sip of water, to make it easy for them. To make them swallow that zakkum, digest that zakkum. ثم إن لهم عليها لشوبا Min hameen. What is the drink? Hameen. Boiling hot water. Boiling hot water. You want a drink? Here you drink. وَإِن يَسْتَغِيثُوا What does Allah say in the Quran Surah Al-Kahf? وَإِن يَسْتَغِيثُوا يُغَاثُوا بِمَاءٍ كَالْمُهْلِ لِيَشْوِي الْوُجُوهِ بِئْسَ الشَّرَابُ وَسَاءَتْ مُرْتَفَقًا People are, they eat zakkum, they're dying, they're squealing, they're crying. Ya Allah, please give us some water, we need to drink. Give us something to swallow this. What happens? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders the khazana, orders the gods, they give them muhl. Muhl, some ulama say, it's boiling oil. Boiling dark oil. Other ulama say, extremely hot water. Other ulama say, it's like the ghassab. It is the pus and blood, that all comes in the sewage of Jahannam. This is their drink. This is what they drink from. وَإِنْ يَسْتَغِيثُوا يُغَاثُوا بِمَاءٍ كَالْمُهْلِ يَشْوِي الْوُجُوهِ When they come to drink this muhl, this melted copper or melted silver or extremely hot water, what happens? Just you bring it close to your face to drink and you're forced to drink. It burns your face. يَشْوِي الْوُجُوهِ بِئْسَ الشَّرَابُ Allah is saying, the worst of drinks. بِئْسَ الشَّرَابُ وَسَاءَتْ مُرْتَفَقًا And what about about? What a bad resting place to be in Jahannam. You run away, you are dying from this what you just ate, from this meal you just had, and your drink is from this muhl or from this hameen. Why? Why put yourself in a situation like this? Even for one day, even for half a day. Why does any smart human being put himself through this torture? Put himself through this ghadab? The shade is as such. No refuge, nowhere to go. Hungry, torture. Drinking, torture. Clothes,
what you wear. People of Jahannam have clothes. That's why they say, وَالَّذِينَ كَفْرُوا لَهُمْ قُتِعَتْ ثِيَابٌ مِنْ نَارٍ هَذَانِ خَصْمَانِ اخْتَصَمُوا فِي رَبِّهِمْ فَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا قُتِعَتْ لَهُمْ ثِيَابٌ مِنْ نَارٍ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them clothes from Jahannam. Even your clothes are from Jahannam. قُتِعَتْ لَهُمْ ثِيَابٌ مِنْ نَارٍ يُصَبُّ مِنْ فَوْقِ رُؤُوسِهِمُ الْحَمِيمُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pours the hameem on their heads. يُصْهَرُ بِهِ مَا فِي بُطُونِهِمْ وَالْجُلُودِ This hameem, this boiling water, it makes all your internals melt and your skin almost. يُصْهَرُ بِهِ مَا فِي بُطُونِهِمْ وَالْجُلُودِ وَلَهُمْ مَقَامِعُ مِنْ حَدِيدٍ And the guards are there with these iron and steel whips. كُلَّمَا أَرَادُوا أَن يَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا مِنْ غَمٍّ People start to run away. They want to run away, they want to escape, they start running everywhere. The guards are there. Go back with the whips. كلما أرادوا أن يخرجوا منها من غم أعيدوا فيها Come return وذوقوا عذاب الحريق Taste Didn't you think you're arrogant? Didn't you think you're strong? Didn't you say no, I won't pray? Didn't you say no, I don't want to do this now? I'm not ready yet? Now test Who are you playing with here? That's Allah You are dealing with Allah Al-Jabbar, Al-Mutakabbir, Al-Azim Subhanahu wa Ta'ala It's not a joke We take deen for granted We take the orders of Allah as a joke Wallahi it's not a joke People think, ah, don't worry, I'll live. We see every day in front of our eyes. Friends, mates, 18-year-olds, 17-year-olds, Allahu Akbar, people that are young die more than people that are old. We never learn from our lesson. No, not me, I'm safe, don't worry. Inshallah, something will happen. Inshallah, I will come back on deen. Inshallah, next hajj. Inshallah, next deen. Excuse after excuse, till when? Till you follow this problem? Till you face this? Don't think you're safe. Never think you're safe. It's a problem, it's a disease. If you think you're safe from Jahannam, the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your clothes are this, your bed. Your bed is Jahannam. لَهُمْ مِنْ جَهَنَّمَ مِهَادٍ وَمِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ غَوَاشٍ Jahannam is your bed, and Jahannam is your cover. The dhill, the shade burns you. انطلقوا إلى مَا كُنْتُمْ بِهِ تُكَذِّبُونَ Run, go. Go to what you denied. انطلقوا إلى ظل ذي ثلاث شعب لا ظليل ولا يغني من اللهب The shade of Hammurabi said, it looks like shade, has no shade, and it doesn't protect you from any flame. More heat, more torture. What? Why fall in this? Why do this to yourself? Why suffer so much? Why? For this dunya? For shahawat and desires? Listen, it's not smart if he falls in this mistake. Extreme punishment, designed by Allah. Why expose yourself to this? Why expose yourself to the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And not only that, Jahannam, like I said, subhanAllah, I was thinking and it is ajeeb, wallahi, if we are people of understanding, you realize how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how the perfection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is designed. I was thinking today, any punishment you face in your life, is made softer and easier by three things. Alas? Any punishment you face, grab a kid, torture someone, take him, torture him, punish him. This punishment, 100% must be reduced in three aspects. Number one, he gets used to the punishment. Sahala, if I punish you today, what will happen? First time, Allah, if I whip you, if I torture you, no food, I make you, I hang you from the wall, I whip you every day, I cut you, I hurt you, I wound you, whatever. And then I lose every day to you. What happens after a while? After a while, you get used to it. Ask people in the jail, ask people that were tortured before. The first day, extremely hard. Next day, easier. Third day, easier. Fourth day, easier. So any punishment in this world must be logically diminished. Why? Because you get used to the punishment. Number two, what also makes punishment easier is when you see others around you punished also. Inmates in the cell, inmates in jail, what happens? They start making things easier for each other. They get used to their life. Even people in cell, people are, you know, locked up in a cell alone, 23-hour lockdown, they can't go out, they start speaking to each other. It makes things easier. They see others being tortured, they know others are being tortured, it makes things softer for them. And number three is hope that one day this torture will finish. This ghadab, this punishment is going to end. I will leave jail, this will happen. These three things always make punishment easier. SubhanAllah, the punishment of Jahannam, even them three, even these three things that made punishment easy, did not allow, Allah did not allow them for the kuffar and the non-believers and people in Jahannam. Allah did not allow them. So with getting used to the punishment, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says? Can you get used to the punishment of Jahannam? The punishment of Jahannam always increases. Always, Allah says, فَذُوقُوا فَلَن نَزِيدَكُمْ إِلَّا عَذَابًا. Not only the same punishment increases. So every day you are tasting a new punishment, a higher rank of punishment, a higher level of punishment, or a different type of punishment designed by Allah. Not exactly the people of Jannah. Every day they can never get bored. Every day new na'im, new gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything changes. Like brand new, you never get bored. In Jahannam also, you can never get bored of punishment. Every day, something new. فَذُوقُوا تَيْسِ فَلَن نَزِيدَكُمْ إِلَّا عَذَابًا. You will only increase in punishment. So even this you're deprived of. يعني, you will never get used to the punishment of Jahannam. Number two, people that are with you, inmates of Jahannam, they can sit together, you know what, we're all being punished. And yani, don't worry, خلاص, what can we do? InshaAllah, Allah have rahmah on us, they'll talk. No. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَنْ يَنْفَعَكُمُ الْيَوْمَ إِذْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ فِي الْعَذَابِ مُشْتَرِكُونَ. Even the fact that you are together being punished, it will not help you in Jahannam. Even that will not help you. Will not, when you see others being punished, it will not, Allah will lift this. It will not help you. Not make you feel better in any aspect. How about hope of leaving Jahannam? Ah, don't worry, inshaAllah. We'll leave Jahannam one day. People that are khalidin in Jahannam, Allahu Akbar. The punishment is amazing. Above our understanding, what does khulud mean? What does everlasting torture mean? We don't understand. No one has a concept of infinity. We don't understand. 100 years, a million years, a billion years, 2, 3, 1,000 billion years. Khulud is much more longer. Infinity is much more longer. Khalidin fiha abada. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in one of the hadith, Rasulullah says, in some hadith and some narrations of the ulama, that the people, subhanallah, of Jahannam, they are being tortured day and night, day and night, day and night. In the morning, in the evening, torture, from zakum to this, to that, in the darakat of Jahannam, in the levels of Jahannam, everyone is being tortured. Day and night, day and night. So what happens? They start screaming. They start squealing. They start going off, begging the guards of Jahannam. What's their request? What is their request? Read the book of Allah. They are requesting, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ فِي النَّارِ لِخَزَنَةِ جَهَنَّمْ. Allah is saying in the Quran, they will start begging the guards of Jahannam. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ فِي النَّارِ لِخَزَنَةِ جَهَنَّمْ اُدْعُوا رَبَّكُمْ يُخَفِّفْ عَنَّا يَوْمًا مِنَ الْعَذَابِ. People spending everlasting time in Jahannam, they're asking what? They're asking the angels, begging of the angels, begging of the gods, please, 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 just one day break. يَوْمًا مِنَ الْعَذَابِ. Not 2 days, not 1 week, not 1 month, just one day. قَالُوا أَوَلَمْ تَكُوا تَأْتِيكُمْ رُسُلُكُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. What will the God say to them? No rahmah, no mercy. You disobeyed Allah, now it's torture. Now there's no rahmah. The God will say to them, did the prophets come to you with clear signs? أَوَلَمْ تَكُوا تَأْتِيكُمْ رُسُلُكُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. قَالُوا بَلَى. Yes, yes, it happened. قَالُوا فَدْعُوا. Make dua, scream more, ask more. ما دعاء الكافرين إلا في ضلال. Absolutely useless. Whether you speak, whether you ask, whether you beg, there's no rahmah for you. There's no mercy for you. سواء علينا أجزعنا أم صبرنا ما لنا من محيص. Whether we squeal, we ask, nothing will happen. Nothing will move. No rahmah for you. So the ulama say, subhanAllah, after this, they beg, they find there's no hope from the angels. So they start speaking to Malik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made Malik the Khazin of Jahannam. He is the leader of the gods of Jahannam. He is called Malik. Malik, that's his name. Malik, the Khazin of Jahannam, they start speaking to him. The main god of Jahannam. They start speaking to him, begging him. Ya Malik. How many years the ulama say? Some ulama say 40 years. 40 years of akhirah time, of hereafter time. قولي يا مالك يا مالك. What's the request? ليقضي علينا ربك. All we beg for is us to be destroyed. Just destroy us. Ask Allah to destroy us. خلاص, make us go, become dust. Destroy us, kill our souls, destroy our souls. يا مالك ليقضي علينا ربك. 40 years. Some narrations, 80 years. They begging Malik just to destroy him, to make Allah destroy them. The ulama say, the hadith says, after 80 years, Malik turns to them and says two words. إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. You stay. After 80 years, إِنَّ الْمُجْرِمِينَ فِي عَذَابِ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدُونَ لَا يُفَتَّرُ عَنْهُمْ وَهُمْ فِيهِ مُبْلِسُونَ. The punishment of Allah, the torment of Allah, the everlasting, the torment of Allah, and it will never be decreased for them. لَا يُفَتَّرُ عَنْهُمْ وَهُمْ فِيهِ مُبْلِسُونَ. And in it, they lose hope. لَا يُفَتَّرُ عَنْهُمْ فِيهِ مُبْلِسُونَ. وَنَادَوْ, and then they call, وَنَادَوْ يَا مَالِكْ لِيَقْضِ عَلَيْنَا رَبُّ. Make Allah destroy us. قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. After 80 years, he says, إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. You're staying. You're not leaving. إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ. لَقَدْ جِئْنَاكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ. Then the truth comes to you. لَقَدْ جِئْنَاكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ. مَا أَكْثَرَكُمْ الْحَقِّ كَرِيمٌ. You didn't like the haqq. You refused the haqq. You refused the truth. It's your choice. Now you deserve the punishment. After 80 years, so the people of Jahannam start losing hope completely. Who is the last person remaining to ask? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They start squealing and asking and begging Allah. What do they say? Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. Begging Allah, begging Allah, begging Allah. Ya Allah, the ulama say 1,000 years. 1,000 years before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them, أَلَمْ تَكُنْ آيَاتِي تِتْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ. Didn't my words, my verses, weren't they recited before you, in front of you? أَلَمْ تَكُنْ آيَاتِي تُتْلَى عَلَيْكُمْ فَكُنْتُمْ بِهَا تُكَذِّبُونَ. And you used to deny and say it's a lie. So what do they say? قَالُوا رَبَّنَا غَلَبَتْ عَلَيْنَا شِقْوَتُنَا وَكُنَّا قَوْمًا ضَالِينَ. Our desires, our nafs, Ya Allah, our nafs, our desires, it overcame us. The desires overcame us. وَكُنَّا قَوْمًا ضَالِينَ وَمِسْغَيْدٍ رَبَّنَا أَخْرِجْنَا مِنْهَا فَإِنْ عُدْنَا فَإِنَّا ظَالِمُونَ. Ya Allah, take us out of Jahannam. If we return, we are the worst of creation. We are ظَالِمِينَ. We are oppressors. What does Allah say to them? قَالَ اخْسَأُوا فِيهَا وَلَا تُكَلِّمُونَ. And Allah will say to them, اخْسَأ. Go away. Stay away. اخْسَأ is what you say to a dog. اخْسَأ, اخْسَأ. Go. اخْسَأُوا فِيهَا وَلَا تُكَلِّمُونَ. Don't speak to me. Allah says to them, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. So the ulama say, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this, Jahannam is closed. No voice enters, no voice goes out. Jahannam is closed completely, sealed, never again to be opened. When Allah says, قَالَ اخْسَأُوا فِيهَا وَلَا تُكَلِّمُونَ, and then every single one of them turns blind and deaf, عُمْر, blind. وَصُمْ وَبُمْ, can't speak, can't talk, can't hear and can't see. Allah says in the Quran, عُمْيًا وَبُقْمًا وَصُمًّا. Don't think in Jahannam you can see, in Jahannam you can talk, in Jahannam you can hear. Extreme torture. Punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So why would any smart person choose this path? The path of the ghadab of Allah. The path of the punishment of Allah. And like I said in the beginning, we should all be warned. Who are the first people that will believe will like Jahannam? The authentic hadith. A very, very scary hadith for any believer, anyone that fears Allah, anyone with an atom of iman and fear of Allah in his heart, hears this hadith and should shiver. Rasul said, أول من تسعر بهم النار يوم القيامة. The first people Allah will light Jahannam with them is who? عالم ومنفق وشهيد. A scholar. Yes, scholars, ulama. عالم ومنفق. And a person that spends a lot fi sabilillah, spends a lot charity. ومنفق وشهيد and a martyr. They are the three types of people that will start Jahannam. أما العالم, Allah subhanahu will bring him forth. He will ask him, this scholar, what have you done for deen? The alim will say, Ya Allah, I studied all this knowledge because of your sake. Allah will say, إن كذبت, you're lying. You studied for people to say he's a alim, he's a scholar. MashaAllah, he knows a lot. وَقَدْ قِيل, wasn't this said? Don't come and ask me reward now. So Allah will put him in Jahannam. وَمُنْفِقْ, the person that spends in charity. But what Allah will say, what have you done for the deen? This person will say, Ya Rabb, I spent a lot of money for your sake. يُقَالَ لَهُ كَذَبْتْ, you're a liar. No. You spent? We could say, ah, oh, he's generous, he's kareem. How many people do we know in our time do this? Brother, I spent this to this mosque. I gave this to this to said charity. I gave this and I gave this and I spent this every year. Allahu Akbar, who are you seeking reward from? Keep your sadaqa secret. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the reward. Wa shaheed and a martyr. Allah will ask him, what do you do for my deen? The martyr will say, Ya Rabb, I died for your sake. Allah will say to him, kadhabt, you're a liar. You died in the battle for people to say you have courage. وَقَدْ قِيلَ was said, what do you want from me now? These are the three types of people that will start Jahannam. So no one is safe. No one is safe from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one should be secure, like we said at the beginning. All of us should have this fear. All of us should be continuously aware and alert from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never forget Jahannam. Never forget Hellfire. Never forget the punishment. When you read the Quran next time, don't read the ayat of Jahannam and the verse of Jahannam as if Allah is speaking to the kuffar. No! The kuffar will get the maximum punishment. But Muslims, muwahideen, from the ummah of Rasulullah might get a taste of this. Sinners, people that don't pray, leaving salat, falling in sin, falling in kaba'ir. What will be the condition of Judgment Day? How many years will they spend? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alam. So every one of us should be sincere and honest with himself. Don't say, Allah is Ghafoor Rahim and stop. True, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Ghafoor and is the Rahim. But also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has punishment. So we all should have a balance of both. A balance of fear and hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. None of them should overcome the other completely. Too much hope is no good. And too much fear is also no good. Always a balance between the hope and the fear. I will end the talk inshallah just with a reminder that inshallah, because we are the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have, alhamdulillah, because of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inshallah, 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 we have a very, very easy hisab compared to other nations. Rasulullah says in the hadith, authentic hadith, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Judgment Day will order Adam, Ya Adam, أخرج من ولدك بعث النار. Take out of your progeny the share of Jahannam. So Adam will ask, Ya Allah, what is the share of Jahannam from my nasl, from my progeny? Allah will say, from every 1,000 people, 999 to Jahannam. And one person to Jannah. So from Adam's nasl, from Adam's progeny, from every 1,000, only one person enters Jannah, and 999 are going to Jahannam. The best of ranks on Judgment Day is the Shafa'ah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will intercede for us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's heaps of hope, but please, 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 don't let this hope make you not work. Make you not move and go against your nafs. Break this nafs. Worship Allah. Be patient until death comes. And then enjoy the na'im of Jannah, inshallah, as we speak, inshallah, in our next lecture. But for now, everyone should have this fear factor in his heart. Never ever allow this fear factor to die in your heart and be completely secure from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nas'al Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaj'alna alladhina yastami'una al-qawla fayattabi'una ahsana. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us some people that practice what we need. Jazakumullahu khair wa barakallahu.
Subhanallah walhamdulillah. ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله